Do you consider yourself attractive to women?
I guess I get hit on from time to time.
And you've hit on them?
Absolutely.
And how do they respond to that in general?
In general? Receptively.
Have you ever felt that a woman's led you on?
Yeah, I guess that happens.
And did that make you feel angry?
No one likes to be led on.
How angry? Angry enough to...
No. I'm not that kind of guy. Honestly, I'm... So, when are you gonna turn this thing on?
Are you in a hurry?
No. I'm just curious.
All right, Joey. But you understand why we have to cover this area.
Yeah, sure. You want to get to know me better.
And the better we communicate, the more accurate the test will be.
Makes sense.
Good, great. Then let's continue. Did the detective show you this photograph?
Yes.
So, that evening, did she give you her verbal consent?
Maybe not in so many words.
So how did you know she was willing?
It's just something a guy knows.
She told the police, she said no.
She's a liar.
Yeah, but why would she lie about something like that?
Because she's pissed at me for not calling her.
Respiration, electrodermal response, blood pressure.
Don't you have anything that could, like, get inside my brain?
Well, your brain can deceive itself, but it can't deceive your body. If you give a deceptive response, your autonomic nervous system will trigger a fear reflex. It's not something that you can consciously control.
Well, like I told you, I got nothing to hide.
That's good. Then let's go. I'm going to ask you the first question.
Do you intend to answer all my questions truthfully?
Yes.
Is your middle name James?
Yes.
Have you ever had intercourse with a woman against her will?
No.
Do you have fantasies about raping women?
No.
I'm getting a response.
What do you mean?
Your body reacted to the last three questions I asked you.
I am kind of nervous.
You don't have to be nervous if you're telling the truth.
I don't like being accused.
I'm not accusing you of anything. All I'm doing is asking you these questions.
Can we start over?
Sure.
Okay.
Did you force Marcy Wilkins to have sexual intercourse with you?
No.
I just got a big response.
You're trying to set me up. You're trying to play mind games with me.
No, all I'm trying to do is get the truth.
No, you're not. All right, you're setting me up.
No.
You and those cops.
Whoa.
You're trying to nail me for something that I didn't do.
Okay, let's move.
The bitch wanted it. She wanted it. I want my lawyer!
Go,
I want
Amanda.
My lawyer!
Come on! Come on!
You okay? Oh.
Come yeah, on, I Amanda. Think so.
Come on.
You thought giving a polygraph test was a safe line of work.
First time I've been physically injured in 15 years.
Punk, now I'll go run into his rich daddy. Next thing you know, we'll have F. Lee Bailey breathing down our neck.
I'm gonna talk to the Dean of Student Affairs. I think that kid's dangerous.
You know, I'd like to put a tattoo on that kid's forehead. Warning, do not allow yourself to be alone with this person.
Quite a few men I wouldn't mind doing that to. Present company excluded.
Nurse's station, may I help you?
It's a pretty deep gash. I think I'm gonna need some stitches.
Hi, can I help? I'm new. I'm Dr. Peter Clayman. I'm a real doctor, honest. You know, this hurts a lot less if you don't watch. So, is this an occupational hazard?
You might say that.
Now, we could talk about the weather.
Oh, I'm sorry. Am I being unfriendly?
Oh, that would certainly make you an exception. Seems like everybody in this town goes out of their way to be friendly.
Well, it's a friendly little town. Are you from elsewhere?
How'd you guess?
You have that elsewhere look about you.
Really? Thought I was concealing it so well. All right, I would go easy on this for a few days. All right? You're welcome.
So I guess I'll be seeing you around, this being such a small town and everything.
Oh, well, good. I'd like that.
Thanks.
Yeah, we should be leaving too. How are you?
I'm good.
I was right. Joey called up Daddy, now we got the family lawyer all over us.
Is his confession gonna stick?
Who knows? How's the doctor?
Seems like a nice guy. Thanks.
Sure. You need help getting in?
No, I got it. Thanks for driving me.
Jill, I just want you to know Linda and I are having divorce papers drawn up.
Well, I'd say I was sorry, but I know that's what you wanted.
I just want you to hear it from me.
Keep me posted.
I will.
Thanks. Pick one and don't let me see it. You got it? Okay, let's start. Is it a club?
No.
Is it a heart?
Yes.
That's a deception. Is it a spade?
No.
Another deception. Face card?
No.
It's a face card. Queen of spades?
Yes.
King of spades?
No.
Oh. Just flunk deception 101. Now, imagine if the stakes were raised and you were being accused of a crime. Well, the fear impulse would be that much higher.
Hi.
Hi.
How's your hand?
Looks much better.
Good. You like old movies?
Been the best.
Yeah. They didn't have what I wanted.
Which is what?
Errol Flynn, they died with their boots on.
Olivia de Havilland?
Oh, she knows her movies. How about you? What are you looking for?
Oh, anything with Katharine Hepburn, but I can't find one I haven't seen.
What about, Alice Adams?
I haven't seen that.
Oh, here, it's good. It's a good romance. Prince Charming comes and takes her away at the end.
But now I don't have to see it.
No, I didn't give anything away. No, the fun part is watching how they get there.
Okay. I'll give it a try.
I have to be honest. I asked Dr. Winbury about you. He said you were a professor of criminology, that you'd written articles and books.
Well, I guess I'll have to ask Dr. Winbury about you.
I have a better idea. Why don't I write down my phone number, and if you get a chance, you give me a call. I'll tell you anything you want to know. Do you know if Katharine Hepburn and Errol Flynn ever made a movie together?
I don't think so.
Yeah? They wouldn't have been right for each other anyway.
See ya.
Yeah. There's the board right there.
Excuse me. Sorry.
Statistics show that pyromaniacs get sexually aroused when they start fires.
So in a way, they're not much different from exhibitionists.
No, I mean, sexual dysfunction is really the root cause of a whole spectrum of crimes. We'll take this up again on Friday, okay? Hello?
Hi, Jill. It's Mac. I hope your wrist's all better.
It's getting there.
Good, because we need your services. A young woman was murdered last night.
Della Ramsey, enrolled at the college, studying for a master's in fine arts. Family's from upstate New York.
Motel housekeeper found her at 8:30 this morning. She checked in around 10 o'clock last night by herself.
Preliminary medical report says death by strangulation. Looks like it was done with some kind of a thin cord or wire, but we didn't find any weapon at the scene.
No sign of forced entry, so it's possible she was expecting a visitor.
Also possible she'd had intercourse. We'll have to wait for the lab.
We did find her appointment book. It was mostly class schedules, midterms, papers due. But there were some entries of some dates she had with a man named Peter Clayman. That's right, new doctor in town, the guy who stitched up your wrist. Just moved out from Seattle. He leased a house over in Lake Winnetta.
We ran a computer check. Guy's never even had a traffic ticket.
Says he was home by himself last night, so we can't confirm his alibi.
So how did he react when you suggested a polygraph?
We didn't suggest it. He did.
So what do you think?
I think we'll have a better idea what to think after he takes the test. It's the beauty of having you around.
Looks pretty relaxed.
And we'll see how relaxed he is once he's hooked up to the machine.
Mac, it's not a machine. It's an instrument.
Well, yeah. I'll try to remember.
Hello?
Hello, Dr. Clayman. I'm the polygraph examiner.
I'm glad.
Why are you glad?
Because I've heard you're very good.
What I am is experienced, which is good for people who are telling the truth. Sit down. May I call you Peter?
Please.
Do you know why you're here?
Yes.
Have you ever taken a polygraph before?
No.
Well, let me tell you what we're going to be doing here. We're going to sit here for a while and talk, get to know each other.
So you're not just going to come out and ask me, did you do it?
No, it's a little more complicated than that. First, I need to get some background information, and then we need to discuss your relationship with the victim. So just relax.
That might be a little hard under the circumstances.
Well, I'll help you get there.
I'm sure you will.
I'm going to be asking you questions that'll be very specific. It just require a yes or a no.
And what if I don't know the answer to some of the questions?
No, we won't get into any gray area. Everything will be very straightforward, very black and white.
You make it sound simple.
It is.
I've begun to think that the truth is usually a lot more complicated than it seems.
Well, yes, if you're talking about an abstract philosophical concept, I'd have to agree. But what we're doing here is trying to determine the extent to which you are or are not being deceptive. And that's something that I can measure.
They were right. You're very good.
So, are you ready?
Could I ask you a favor?
Sure.
Have a quick smoke.
You're a doctor.
I know, just every now and then.
Well, I really wish that you wouldn't, because the nicotine affects your internal functions.
Oh. All right.
Okay. Question one. Is today Wednesday?
Yes.
Were you and Della Ramsey sexually involved prior to her death?
Yes.
Do you intend to mislead me about anything during this examination?
No.
Did you have sex with Della Ramsey on the night of Tuesday, March 20th?
No.
Have you ever fantasized about killing someone?
No.
Did you kill Della Ramsey?
No.
Do you have any knowledge of who killed Della Ramsey?
No.
I'm going to ask that question again. Do you have any knowledge of who killed Della Ramsey?
No.
Seem to hit on that have you ever fantasized question.
Yeah, well, that was my control question. Of course, he's fantasized about killing someone who hasn't. But the point is, he was confident and he knew he was going to pass the test.
Does that mean he's innocent?
Well, he's innocent of Della Ramsey's murder. I mean, beyond that.
Okay. You're the expert.
There was a sexual element to the murder. You're aware of that?
Yes, but they weren't very specific.
Well, we'll need to explore that aspect of your relationship with her.
Oh. You want to know about the sex? Library.
The university library?
That's right. She sat down across from me and started a conversation. She was very attractive, intelligent. She seemed a little bit wild.
You mean she was the aggressor?
The aggressor, the initiator. She was very experienced for her age.
And how many times did the two of you have intercourse, roughly?
Oh, I can tell you exactly. Three times. Three.
And when was the last time that the two of you had intercourse?
About 10 days ago. The truth is, I'd burned out. I told her I didn't think we should see each other anymore.
Was that before the sex or after?
Before. She had a very persuasive way about her.
You mean seductive, don't you?
That too. Yeah, it feels very awkward talking to you about all this. When this is over, there's not going to be much you don't know about me.
Well, that's the idea. Well, if he's showing that slow of an R in respiration pattern, he has to be consciously controlling his breathing. He's probably using some kind of countermeasure.
Countermeasure? Could you check it out? Jill?
Hmm? Oh, yeah, why don't you fax it to me and I'll take a look at it and I'll get back to you.
I'll send it right over.
Great, talk to you later. It's Jill Ross.
Reached 555-3822. Please leave a message.
Hi, it's Jill Ross calling.
Hello?
Oh, hi.
Yeah, I just walked in the door. I'm glad you called.
Oh, well...
Listen, I'd like to take you to lunch. How about tomorrow?
Lunch?
It's not against the rules, is it?
Well, they're still investigating...
I passed the test. Doesn't that make me safe?
Technically. Well, I mean, it makes you safe enough. I mean, to have lunch with.
Jill!
Oh, hey, Matt.
Hey.
Finally got around to copying this report.
Much appreciated.
Anything new on the Ramsey case?
Well, we're having a hard time determining exactly what was used to strangle her. We do have a lead, though.
Hmm.
Turns out Della had a boyfriend. She was seeing him up to the time she met Klayman.
So have you questioned him?
First, we gotta find him. He hasn't been to any of his classes since the murder. We're looking.
Well, if you need my help, let me know.
I have a feeling you'll be getting more work out of this one.
See ya.
See ya.
Right.
Okay, well.
Yeah. Hi. Hi. Reservation for Klayman.
Are you Mrs. Klayman?
No.
Would you like to be seated or
whatever? I'll just wait.
Hi.
Hi.
I hope you haven't been waiting too long.
Just got here.
What can I get for you?
What's up, Skill?
You know, I'm at a distinct disadvantage.
Hmm.
Well, you know all this stuff about me, and I hardly know anything at all about you.
So go ahead and ask, and I'll decide if I want to answer.
Those weren't the rules the first time around.
Well, the circumstances were different.
All right. How old were you when you lost your virginity?
Do you always ask people that on their first date?
You're the first woman I've ever asked that question.
Well, then I was old enough.
Okay. Was it painful or pleasurable?
Both.
Were you in love with him?
Thought so.
How long did the relationship last?
Until I found out that he was also sleeping with someone else.
That must have been humiliating.
And other things.
Did you sleep with him again after you found out?
I slept with him one more time. Then I regretted it.
Good. I feel much better now.
Listen, you know there's that Rotary Club dinner tomorrow night?
Right.
I know it's late notice, but you want to go with me?
Oh, I'd really like to, but I have other plans.
Oh, that's okay. I just thought it'd be a good chance for us
to
talk.
Well, it would be, but maybe we can do it some other time?
Absolutely.
I got to go because I've got a class in about 5 minutes. I'll call you.
Okay, great. See ya.
I like big kitchens. Do you want a glass of wine?
Sure.
I forgot to put candles on the tables.
Where are they?
They're in the sideboard in the drawer.
He's okay?
Great. Yeah.
Oh, that looks beautiful.
Well, looks aren't everything.
Cook like this for yourself?
I try to stay in practice, but actually, you're the first dinner guest I've had since I moved in.
Oh, wow. What an honor.
There you go.
Thanks.
Yeah.
So what drove you out of the big city? The smog, the pollution, the noise?
No, I had a bad experience. I got involved with the wrong woman. With the wrong women. It was a weird situation. There were these two sisters. One who encouraged my pursuit, the other pursued me. And it just got very messy.
How messy? Oh, I'm sorry.
No, it's all right. It's all right. I learned from it. If a woman becomes obsessed, run for the hills.
Or run to a small town very far away.
Right. No. I'm all right with it now. It's just a bad situation. I'd like to get out of hand. Anyway.
Do you play?
I know a few pieces. It's brand new. I got it as a housewarming gift for myself.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, here, Sam.
so powerful.
Rachmaninoff was 19 when he composed that. Sounds like the music of an old soul, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It's just A, G sharp, C sharp.
Spooky.
And that?
Words can't describe that.
A little awkward. You want to stop by your class on Friday?
It's okay. You just caught me off guard.
Look, excuse me. We've been friends for a long time.
Sorry.
I don't know, I'm feeling kind of tongue-tied.
It's okay.
Can we go in there?
Sure.
All right, here goes. I was thinking that maybe we could go out sometime. Is that a bad idea?
No.
Peter Clayman called. He said he wanted you to call him back at the clinic.
Is that who you had plans with on Saturday night?
Look, Mac, I'm sorry.
Jill, he's a suspect in a murder case.
No, he passed the polygraph test.
We're still investigating. No one's been eliminated.
You know me. You know that I wouldn't be seeing anyone if I wasn't absolutely sure.
You're seeing him?
Mac, I appreciate your concern. I really do.
No, look, forget the personal stuff, Jill. It's a conflict of interest.
I know what I'm doing. Excuse me. Hello?
Delivery for Jill Ross.
Thank you. To our next piano duet, Peter. Ooh, I'm in trouble now, Dexter. Hello?
Hey, Jill. It's Jonesy. Listen, we picked up that kid Della was dating.
Okay, look,
Hey, Jill, how's it going?
Great. You here on the job?
Yeah, Matt called. I guess he has a new suspect in that murder.
See ya.
Sorry. Guess I jumped the gun.
I had to disqualify you.
Because I'm seeing Peter Clayman?
Think about it. You run this guy dirty and the results get challenged.
All right. Do you have a problem with me observing?
How'd you feel when Della told you she was seeing someone else?
I was mad. I mean,
bummed out. I really cared about her.
How mad were you?
I yelled at her, okay. I said some mean things, but it was just in the heat of emotion.
Did you get physical with her?
No. No way, never. Maybe it crossed my mind, but I did not touch her.
Were you with Della Ramsey at the Main Lane Motel on the night of Tuesday, March 20th?
No.
Did you have sexual intercourse with Della Ramsey on the night of Tuesday, March 20th?
No.
Did you kill Della Ramsey?
No.
He's not your guy.
Back to square one.
I'm early.
You certainly are.
I guess I could go and come back later.
Good.
Or, I could come in now.
Hello?
Hello.
Peter?
No, it's Mac.
Oh, hi, Mac.
Can you swing by the station? There's something I need to discuss with you.
Okay.
Hey.
Hi.
Morning. Sit down. An eyewitness came forward on the Ramsey case. She's a waitress at some greasy spoon off exit 14. She says she was up here on the night of the 20th at a bar across the street from the motel.
Yeah, and?
She says she saw a man leaving the room where Della was murdered.
Did she give a description?
Yeah. Short dark hair, clean shaven, under 6 feet tall, 170 pounds, 35 to 40, handsome, built. Wore a tan jacket, probably camel hair.
Why didn't she come forward until now?
That's what we intend to find out. She's coming in tomorrow. We'll talk to her. And show her a lineup.
Oh. Let me guess. You want Peter to be part of the lineup. Do you know how many men fit that description?
We had her sit down with a sketch artist. This just came in over the fax.
So who's gonna tell him?
I could go up there myself, or I could leave it up to you.
I'd appreciate that. He didn't do it, Mac.
I'm not saying he did, but he's got to be in that lineup.
He'll be there.
Good.
Anything else?
That's all.
Against feeling this good.
Actually, there's a reason why I came here.
Uh-huh.
A witness came forward in the Ramsey case.
Well, that's good.
An artist did a sketch from the description. Mm-hmm. And there's a resemblance.
His resemblance to me? Really?
It's not a big deal. And I'm sure it's gonna be all right, but they want you to appear in a lineup.
Lineup? I thought that when you passed a polygraph, that...
It's just a lineup. And when she doesn't pick you, that...
It's a she. All right, so what do? I'd have to go in there and stand next to some other guys and just...
There's nothing to worry about.
All right, just... You tell me when, I'll be there.
Okay, let's get through this one more time. You drove out to Blackie's Tavern to meet some friends. You arrived, you waited for your friends to show up, you had a couple of beers.
No, one beer. Only one.
Okay, you had one beer, and at 10:45, you got up and left.
Yeah, that's right. You see, I remember because I looked at my watch and at the clock behind the bar.
Okay, you walked out of the bar, across the highway, into the parking lot to the May Lane Motel.
Yeah. I mean, they got all these signs that say, no parking for Blackies, but nobody ever checks.
Can I sit in?
Sure. This is Jill Ross. She works with us. Jill's Susie Marsh.
Hi.
Okay, so you found your car.
Yeah. So I was parked facing one of the rooms, right? So I'm digging around in my purse for my keys, and I hear a door open. And I look over, and I see this guy coming out of number 6. He's real sharp looking, wearing one of those camel hair coats. It just struck me kind of weird. A guy like that coming out of some sleazy motel room.
You remember anything else about this guy?
Yeah, he seemed kind of nervous. You know, he wouldn't look me in the eye. And then he just took off, like he was in a hurry.
Tell us again, what took you so long to come forward?
Well, I'd heard about the murder on the radio, but I just never connected it to that motel. Till I was waiting on these college kids at the place where I work, and they were all talking about it, and I heard one of them mention the May Lane Motel. That's when it clicked.
Look him over carefully. I need you to be absolutely sure.
That's him.
Which number?
Number three. Number three, that's the guy that I saw coming out of that room.
You're positive?
You kidding? Get a guy that looks like that. He's gorgeous. She's wrong.
Guess that's possible.
You don't think so?
Pretty damn strong identification.
It was dark. It happened a few weeks ago. She only saw him for a moment.
There's something else. We got the phone records from room 6 on the night of the murder. The call was placed to Clayman's number at 1015.
What does that prove?
Someone in that room made contact with him a half hour before the murder. Now he's been ID'd by an eyewitness.
Do it, Mac. You have to trust me.
I need more than that. I need evidence. I need facts.
So let him take the polygraph again. We'll get Sam in here. He knows the case. He's completely objective. I mean, what are the chances of him passing that test twice with independent examiners? If he is guilty, he will show a response.
Yeah, unless he...
Unless what? Unless he's a freak of nature. I mean, even if he's a complete sociopath, he knows the difference between a truth and a lie.
The fact is, you crossed the line.
Okay, I crossed the line. But that does not invalidate my argument. Let's say that he beat me. There is no chance that he can beat Sam, too.
Okay, I'll give him one more polygraph, but I'm not making any promises.
Thank you.
You know, I should arrest this guy right now.
He'll be there. I guarantee it.
Picked me? You told me there was nothing to worry about. You said everything was going to be okay.
Look, her ID only places you at the scene of the crime during the time of the murder. It's
God.
Only circumstantial.
She's nuts! Why would she pick me? All right, so now what?
I talked to Mac. And he's agreed not to arrest you if you take a second polygraph. But it won't be me. It'll be a different examiner. But if you run clean with him, it's going to make a big impression. Peter, look, it's the exact same procedure. It's just someone else asking the questions.
Right, and what if he interprets my responses differently than you did? What if he makes mistakes? What if he's not as good?
Everything will be fine as long as you're telling the truth.
I am telling the truth.
I know that. And you know that. That's why there is nothing to worry about. I promise you.
Thank you.
Well, I'd be in bad shape if you didn't believe me. Within the last 5 years, have you told any lies to avoid getting in trouble?
No.
Were you with Della Ramsey at the Main Lane Motel on Tuesday night, March 20th?
No.
Did you have sexual intercourse with Della Ramsey on Tuesday night, March 20th?
No.
Did you kill Della Ramsey? I'd like to ask some of the questions over again. Did you have sexual intercourse with Della Ramsey on the night of March 20th?
No.
Did you kill Della Ramsey?
No.
Do you know anyone who would want to hurt Della Ramsey?
No.
Okay, Dr. Clayman, let's take a break here.
Well?
Well, I'm not so sure.
What do you mean?
I mean, he's inconsistent. Some he's sitting in and some he's not. Look here, he's sitting on, do you know anyone that would want to hurt Della Ramsey? But on the other relevance...
No, he's up, he's down, he's all over the place.
Right, it almost looks like he's trying to use countermeasures.
Countermeasures? You mean he's trying to beat it? So what's your verdict?
Well, at this point, I'd have to say it's inconclusive. I can't say if he did or didn't do it. Sorry, Mac.
Jonesy... Can you take Sam out and get him a cup of coffee?
Yeah.
I'm concerned, Jill.
He knows that the eyewitness ID'd him. He is nervous. He shook up.
I'm not concerned about him. I'm concerned about you.
Inconclusive.
I didn't even know that was a valid result.
I thought it shows you're either lying, oh, I'm sorry, being deceptive, or it clears you.
You were much more nervous this time.
Wouldn't you be?
No. Not if I were telling the truth. No, I didn't mean...
But you did. You asked me to take another test, and suddenly I've gone into the gray area. I'm not quite guilty. I'm not quite innocent.
Well, but there is no gray area, Peter. You didn't do it. You could never be that kind of person.
However, yours is just one opinion. So, you and Mac, was there ever something between you?
No. No, that has nothing to do with this.
You sure?
Peter, where are you going?
Got the late shift at the clinic.
Peter.
Yeah, I got the warrant. But we got to get there. I think we're really very good.
You want some place?
Yeah.
This is Jill Ross. I'm the polygraph examiner working on that case with the Alton Police Department.
Oh, hi. You got her fax?
Yeah, thanks. Paulette Gideon, can you tell me the connection between her and Peter Clayman?
Well, apparently they were dating, and after the sister reported her missing, he was the first one we questioned.
I see. And was he ever considered a suspect in the case?
Oh, yeah, but we cleared him pretty quickly.
How's that?
Passed the polygraph test.
And this Paulette Gideon, was she ever found?
Nope. File's still open on her. She hasn't turned up anywhere so far, alive or dead.
You lied. You had taken a polygraph. Who's Paulette Gideon?
She's the woman I was involved with in Seattle.
Yeah, well, this woman disappeared and was never heard from again.
That's right.
Yeah, well, what else don't I know? What else haven't you told me?
Wait a second.
No! I put myself out on a limb for you, and you lied to me.
I lied about taking a polygraph test because I didn't think it mattered.
You didn't think it would matter?
If I had admitted to taking the polygraph test, then I would have had to explain that whole ugly mess to you.
That's right.
There were two sisters, Paulette and Simone Gideon. I met Simone first at a party, and we ended up spending the night together once, one time. I met Paulette about a week later, and, she told me that she was Simone's sister. So I was reluctant, but then she persisted and persisted. And eventually we got involved.
How long did that last?
Until I found out this was a pattern they'd repeated with other men. Simone would develop a crush, and Paulette would come and steal the man away. And so I ended it.
You ended it?
Yeah, I called Paulette and I told her it was over. The next thing I know, Simone shows up at my door. I told her the same thing. I wanted her out of my life. Oh, she went nuts. She started screaming and throwing things. And then she said that if she couldn't have me, nobody could. A couple days later, two police detectives showed up at the hospital. Simone was making these wild accusations. She said that I had murdered her sister and somehow done away with the body.
And they wanted you to take a polygraph.
I volunteered to take a polygraph. That's what innocent people do, isn't it? I passed easily. Well, that really set Simone off. She went crazy. She started stalking me around the clock. She would tell anybody that would listen that I had murdered her sister. I got a restraining order. I moved to a different house. I even got a bodyguard. And nothing would stop her. So I realized that the only way that I could be free of her was to disappear myself. And so I did. That's the truth, Jill. That's it, minus a few gory details.
So what do you think happened to Paulette?
I don't know.
Do you think it's possible that Simone might have followed you here?
No, I don't think so. What?
I think that I might have seen her.
Here? In Alton?
It was just a glimpse. What is Mac gonna think when he finds out you lied about the polygraph?
What do you think?
I think if you lied to me once...
No, wait. I lied about taking a polygraph test. That's it. The rest has been the truth, Joe. Do I look like a murderer?
Yeah, as soon as you can. Okay.
He did pass their polygraph.
Yes, he did.
So that 2 out of 3 with 1 inconclusive. What does that tell you?
It tells me he's pretty good at taking tests. We did a second search of the crime scene. Found this wedge between the mattress and the bed frame. Dr. Clayman?
Detective?
I have a warrant for your arrest.
I believe you.
It's for the murder of Della Ramsey.
So now you read me my rights. I've seen it on television. You have to use handcuffs?
Yes, I do, sir. Just turn around, put your hands behind your head, You have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
Questions regarding the reading assignment?
Yeah. I just want to be clear about this lie detector thing. You really saying it's infallible?
It's a polygraph, not a lie detector.
Yeah. The question is, Professor, is it infallible?
It is an instrument used to measure the responses of the autonomic nervous system.
So, you're saying it's impossible for someone to beat it?
It is a gauge, a tool. It is an instrument, a device.
What about the examiner? What about the possibility of human error?
The skill of the examiner is the determining factor.
So if the examiner was having an off day, or she was being influenced by some external element, is it possible she could be wrong? Professor.
I'd be here if I were you.
No,
things are
too
hot right now.
I know that.
Max furious they let Clayman post bail.
What?
Yeah. His attorney convinced the judge he wasn't a flight risk. All he had to do was put up his cash assets. He's out.
Susie Marsh, did she testify?
Hadn't been for her, we might not have gotten the indictment.
Well, what's going on with her face?
She told us it was a nose job.
Why would she have that done right now?
I don't know. She wants to look good for the jury?
Yeah, but she's some waitress from a greasy spoon.
Nose jobs aren't that expensive.
Yeah, but did you see the car that she was driving? It's a brand new car.
What's your point?
The point is someone should be checking her out.
Well, Joe, come on.
No, I'm serious. There is something wrong about her.
I wish I could help you out.
Now, Jonesy, look. I have been investigating criminal behavior for the past 15 years. Give me the benefit of the doubt here. Where does she work?
Flora's Diner.
Don't tell Mac.
Are you kidding? Mac would know my butt.
Hello?
Want some coffee?
No, actually, I was just looking for Susie.
Oh, she don't work here no more.
She get fired?
No, she quit. She grabbed her last paycheck and took off.
Oh, shoot, I don't think I have her home address.
You're not a reporter, are you?
No, honestly.
Hey.
You don't have any idea why she quit, do you?
Who wouldn't quit a dump like this?
Thanks. Hi, Susie, it's Jill Ross. Do you remember me?
Oh, yeah, sure. You work at the police department.
Can I come in?
What's up?
It's just a simple procedure. It won't take long.
Oh, well, I was kind of just fixing dinner.
Mac really wanted me to get this done tonight.
Yeah, sure.
Thanks. Could I put this somewhere?
Oh, yeah.
Great. That'd be great. Have you ever seen one of these before?
No.
Well, let me explain. This is just purely routine. All witnesses in murder cases are required to take this test.
Oh, you know, the cops didn't mention anything to me about having to take any tests.
No, I know. This is just standard procedure. I mean, I promise that this will be completely painless. I mean, you've got nothing to hide.
No, of course not.
Well, let's get to it then. This will just take a few minutes and then I'll be out of here.
You know, I really don't see why it's necessary. I mean,
do have the right to refuse. But if you do, then I'm going to have to tell the prosecutor and the policeman, and they're going to want to know if there's a problem.
You know, I really never been too good at taking tests, you know.
Excuse me, I'd appreciate it if you didn't smoke, because the nicotine can affect the results of the test.
Oh, yeah.
Come here. Come sit down. We're just going to chat for a while and get to know each other, and then I'll explain everything to you. Okay?
Great.
Don't worry about being nervous. Most people get nervous when they get hooked up to a polygraph, even the honest ones. Okay, are you ready?
Yeah.
Great. First question. Is your middle name Jean?
Yes.
Did you go to Blackie's Tavern the night of March 20th?
Uh-huh.
I need you to answer with a yes or a no.
Yes.
Do you intend to deceive me with any of the questions we've discussed?
No.
On the night of March 20th, did you see Peter Clayman exit room 6 at the Main Lane Motel?
Yes.
Do you know anyone who would want to hurt Peter Clayman?
No.
Okay.
How'd I do?
Well, I won't know until I have a chance to analyze the charts.
But I did okay, right?
Oh, I'm sure you did fine if you were telling the truth.
Is there any chance that a machine could be wrong?
Well, I've been doing this for 15 years, and it hasn't been wrong yet. You worried about something?
Oh, no.
Well, I really appreciate your cooperation. I'll be sure to note that on the report.
Ah, his lover.
Did he play the Rachmaninoff for you, too? You think running into him at the video store was a coincidence? He followed you there. I watched him slip into the back door and pretend to bump into you. You have no idea who you're dealing with.
Then you do.
I don't think there's anyone who knows who he really is. But I'll tell you what I know.
Talk to me. Peter Clayman is a cold-blooded killer. Do you have evidence?
He told you I was a crazy one, didn't he? That I was obsessed with him? That I stalked him?
No, what he told me was that he had an affair with your sister. That she disappeared and that you blamed him.
My sister and I were very close. Until Peter came into our lives. He'd found out we were sisters before he even met us. It was all premeditated. Seducing me. Seducing Paulette. And playing us one against the other. But then we started comparing notes. And we realized how much he'd been manipulating us, lying to us.
Yes, but being a liar does not make someone a killer.
Paulette couldn't believe it either. She couldn't let go. I told her to just walk away, but she had to confront him. That very same night she disappeared, do you think that's a coincidence?
He passed 2 polygraph tests.
Because he believes his own lies!
You want to talk about lies? What about the lies that Susie Marsh has been telling the police?
Can't you see? If I didn't do anything, he would have gotten away with it again.
But you have to have evidence.
The people here believe he did it. That's all that matters.
Look, you need to go to the police, and you need to tell them that Susie Marsh...
No! You're not listening to me. See, Peter Clayman is a pathological liar.
Peter Clayman is still innocent until he's proven guilty.
I don't believe you. You're just like my sister. I warned her.
I will take you to see the chief of police. You can tell them your story.
You don't understand. You don't know how dangerous he is.
Simone, put down the gun.
I'm sorry. I don't want to do this.
Simone!
The real estate agent. At least for the house.
Are you all right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's her blood. It's her blood. Why don't you call 911?
Oh,
has been a shooting.
Yeah. Okay. Okay, thanks a lot. Oh, Seattle. They had a dog sniff out Simone's house. They found a skeleton buried in the backyard. Compared dental records. It's the sister.
Cause of death?
Probable strangulation.
So she did kill them both.
Susie confessed. We know Simone spent time in a mental hospital. We also found the PI that Trey's claiming for her. And when we searched her house, we found some of those same condoms in a dresser. Only thing we haven't found is a murder weapon.
Probably never will.
Everything points to Simone. It's hard to believe she had the strength to hold someone down and strangle him. Anyway. I'm sorry, Jill.
Mac, it's all right. I mean, you were just doing your job.
No, I should have trusted your judgment. So what now?
We're gonna take a long trip, try to get our lives together.
And what about your job?
You mean as a professional truth finder? I think I'll put it on sabbatical.
Send us a postcard.
Okay.
Jill?
Mm-hmm.
I'll miss you.
Thinking about?
Nothing. Everything.
I'm gonna check around the house, make sure we didn't forget anything.
Where's that suitcase you said I could borrow?
Oh, it's in the guest house. I'll get it.
You finished checking upstairs?
Like some kind of thin cord or wire.
It's hard to believe she had the strength to hold someone down and strangle
them. Oh, boy, I'd be in bad shape if you didn't believe me.
Jill?
What's wrong? What's the matter?
You did it.
Did what? They never did find the murder weapon, did they? Is
So you think I used the piano wire to kill Della?
Where is it?
What if I told you it broke and I threw the wire away? Would you believe me? Would you believe me? No. Don't say anything. Your eyes said it all.
I'm sorry. Is your first name John?
Yes.
Do you intend to mislead me about anything during this test?
No.
Do you live at 330 Garden Avenue?
Yes.
Do you know anyone who would want to hurt your wife, Angela?
No.
Have you ever physically hit your wife, Angela?
No.
Is today Monday?
Yes.
Did you beat your wife, Angela, to death on Saturday, October the 3rd?
No.